Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in our playlist, Advanced Development in Grasshopper. I am recording this video from the future because when I first recorded this playlist, it was around 2021, 2022. And since then, a lot of things have happened in the Rhino world, and I'm recording this video in 2024 with Rhino 8 already out on the street and with Grasshopper, and in particular in the new version of Grasshopper, the C# script components and all the script components in general have gotten massive updates. So since all this playlist was recorded using Rhino 7 and using the old version of the C# script component, this video is for you to watch so that you can, if you are using Rhino 8, to follow this playlist so that you can see what actually is different and what is really similar from what you have to what you're going to be seeing in the videos, all right? So what you can notice is that if I open Rhino 8 and the new version of Grasshopper, you can see that in the script tab, I now have like several versions of different script components, and I have this general script component. So if I want to now use the C# script component, I have two ways of doing that. I can just download the C# script component and start using it, or I can drag the script component and then click here on the button C, which will convert it into a C# script component. All right. What happens now is that if I double click on the script component, you can see that the editor for the C# script component has gotten a massive, massive update. And in my opinion, a much, much nicer, really good improvement. So if you have watched the previous video where we went over the C# script component in Rhino 7, you're going to notice that in Rhino 8, the editor now looks much nicer. It looks much cleaner. So some things I'm going to go, I cannot, in this case, at least with this version, I cannot control and mouse wheel to zoom in. I have to go to tools, I have to go to options, and I have to go here to manually change the size of the typeface. So now I made it a little bigger so that we can all see. And you can see that the editor is pretty similar. At least the structure of the script instance is very similar. We have the libraries, we'll talk about that. We have the instance, so the main class that drives what the component does. And we have the main function, which, as we explained in the previous video, is the one where you're going to write whatever you want your component to do. All right. Similarly, if you just drop a component and you open it right away, you will get generic types for your inputs and your outputs. But one thing that is very nice from the Rhino 8 version is that now, if you want to change those types, if I go to X, if I right click and I say, this is going to be a point and Y is going to be a double, for example, you can see that the editor has updated in real time and I don't need to close and open it to get those changes. So that is something very nice as well. I also want to point out that the autocomplete feature works much nicer and much more reliant, much more, much better in general than it used to work in the previous version. So if I type now X dot, and you can see that I have a large selection of things to choose from, or if I do Y dot, then I have like a breakdown, a drop down of all the options that I have. So that is working much, much nicer. But on top of that, you can see that the editor itself has a bunch of other things. So for example, I can open here a panel and I can switch from between searching in my code. I can now take a look at the templates that I can use. We're not going to take a look at those because we want to be using for this playlist always the script instance template. You can see that there are some examples. We don't have them yet, but maybe they're going to be developed in the future. And a quick access to the Rhino Common and the Grasshopper SDKs, the documentation. We don't know what this is yet. We're going to take a look at that farther down in this playlist. All right. I can close this panel, but I can also open a panel here at the bottom. So I'm going to open this panel, and you can see that something that is also really nice is that now the editor comes with its own terminal. So if I drop a panel here, you remember that I could use the print statement to just print some text to the output of this component. So if I now run this, you see, if I run now this, I get the hi message still on the output, but I also get it here on the terminal, which means that maybe now to take a look at errors or to print values, I don't quite need to have a panel here. I can have like a full screen editor and I can just take a look at what's going on here on the terminal. And also something that they have already also improved is that now, just like in Visual Studio, we have access to the console write now, write line, console write line method. And that method connects both with the terminal here and with the panel, which is also a nice improvement. So if you're coming from Visual Studio and from console application development, you might be used to writing console write line, which is also a little more flexible than the print method. Okay, so down in the future, in all the videos on this playlist, whenever you see me writing print, you may just want to write console write line. That's going to be the same thing. It's going to work equally fine. There's other features I also want to take a look at. So for example, now we have a full file tab where we can save the progress, where we can close, etc., etc. We have a minimap, so I can actually here go to toggle minimap and take a and look at this kind of mini browser for the code, which is also very common in other editors. So that is very nice, I have to say. And we can also toggle white spaces. So you can see how here, now I have these tiny dots that represent how many white spaces there are in the code. This is also a very common feature in other code editors. And I have an options tab. So here, this is where I change the typeface and the size of my fonts and some other options for making this toolbar a little bigger, a little smaller, etc., etc. This windows is basically doing what I've already done with the buttons. You can see here that there are options to add override methods for preview and for insert before and after. We don't know what this means yet, but we will see what these do farther down on this playlist. And a couple of things that are very interesting is that this is really, really nice. They added the capacity to add breakpoints. Breakpoints meaning places where when you execute the code, the execution stops there and you can take a look at what the code and what the state of the values look like at that time during the execution. All right, so we will take a look at that farther down in this playlist. I'm going to make a video right now about how to use breakpoints in the editor. Okay, beautiful. So I'm going to move the breakpoint. Okay, and then I'm going to run the editor. It looks perfectly fine. So just bottom line, if you are watching this playlist from the future and you're using Rhino 8 or whatever, Rhino 9 maybe, I don't know, and you see that all the videos on this playlist are using the older version and the editor, don't freak out. It's pretty much the exact same thing. It's just that the modern version, the Rhino 8 version, has better autocomplete, it's a bit cleaner, you can type code anywhere, and it has a few more features for terminal dumping and a few more features for breakpoints, which makes the development experience in the C# script component much, much nicer than in the previous version. Okay, so I'm actually quite happy about the overhaul that this component took. Okay, beautiful. So with that, I'm going to let you continue into this playlist. Again, remember, if you see that the editor looks different from what you have, is because you are watching this from the future and these videos were recorded with an older version of Rhino, but the component looks and works, the component works exactly the same thing or even better now. Okay, thank you very much. And if you like this video, maybe like the video, subscribe to the channel, say hi in the comments, join us on Discord, etc., etc. All right, see you on the next video. Bye-bye.